Welcome, this is Plant Smart Living with Farmer Fred. I'm really glad you could join me today. Today's words of encouragement is called the long, slow slide. So stay tuned. So as you may have realized, you know, the world we live in today, it's basically anti-health, our friends, our family. You know, we're really not interested in regaining our health, or a lot of them aren't anyhow. And so, you know, we feel like we're loners out there in the world sometimes. And so I know for me and a few others, these words of encouragement have just really been helpful for me along this narrow path that we're on. And so today's essay, again, is titled The Long, Slow Slide. My descent into illness was as uninteresting as it was ordinary. I wasn't doing anything especially deadly or remarkably unhealthy. My diet was probably no different than anyone else's who eats standard American food. I wasn't getting enough movement or exercise, but then, who does? I was probably eating too much crap and watching too much Netflix, but how does that set me apart? All I was doing was living in this culture and following what most people do in this culture. That was enough. Like a neglected plant sitting on a windowsill, you never notice anything really bad happening because the changes are so minor and imperceptible. You're so wrapped up in other things, you just don't get that you're slowly withering away. Perhaps you notice that things aren't quite like they used to be, but it's like a distant belt. You're sad, but you don't know exactly why. You've lost your smile and your vitality, but that's just the way things go. Life is getting less and less worth living, but hey, it's not like you're really sick, so who are you to complain? You avoid the mirror and you move on with the tasks of everyday life. You do what you believe is the important stuff, and when life loses its magic, you just chalk it all up to getting older. And each and every day you edge ever further down the long, slow slide. My slide was not dramatic or noteworthy. I was never rushed to the hospital clutching my heart, and my life wasn't saved in an operating room by brilliant surgeons. I didn't see a white light. I didn't move down a tunnel. None of this makes for a very spellbinding story, and my skills as a writer would be sorely tested if I tried to make any of it fascinating. No, I was just another bloated, sorry-looking, pasty-faced lady, disoriented, suffering from continual vertigo and mental fog, with the usual highly predictable symptoms of metabolic syndrome. I call us the walking wounded. We don't make the headlines. We're just a footnote in the medical literature among the more pressing accounts of sickness and disability in our chronically ill society. We're not disabled yet, and our lives are not at stake yet, and we have several more bland, unremarkable years to live before the really bad stuff starts to happen. That's when you get lots of attention. But if you're just moving steadily along on the long, slow slide, there's nothing much to distinguish you from the majority of the population, and it's really not much of a story. Sometimes it's hard to even recognize that there is a major problem brewing because you're living in a world of people with major problems brewing. In this culture, all you need to push you down the long, slow slide is a little bit of benign neglect and a sprinkling of apathy. Gravity and inertia do the rest of the work. All you've got to do is sit back, but you don't much enjoy the ride. The long, slow slide doesn't have the attention-grabbing excitement of a roller coaster or even the charm of a merry-go-round. It's just the mind-numbing everyday ride that most Americans are on, whether they know it or not. It's the inevitable boring result of not thinking for ourselves and just doing what our culture tells us to do. I'm so lucky that I finally figured out I was going on the long, slow slide before I got to the bottom and stepped off into oblivion. Others have not been as fortunate. Like I said, this is not the most enthralling story in the world. But I gotta tell you, I'm pretty darn thrilled with it myself. Love, Lori. So anyhow, I hope this these words of encouragement have been helpful for you. And, you know, they always give us something to think about and meditate. And so, you know, it's good to have those moments of times of reflection. So anyhow, I just want to thank you for joining me. And so until next time, this is Plant Smart Living with Farmer Fred.